Hi, I'm Clara. Welcome to Viana at Castelo, the O&M base for floating offshore wind projects in Portugal. Principle Power is the engineering designer of the semi-submersible WindFloat technology. And we are the O&M service provider for the WindFloat Atlantic project. It's a 25 megawatt project installed off the coast of Viana de Castelo in Portugal in about 100 meter water depth. It features three 8.4 megawatt turbines from Vestas installed on top of three semi-submersible WindFloat platforms. Today, the WindFloat Atlantic project provides green energy to about 25,000 homes on a yearly basis. The WindFloat Atlantic project is owned by WindPlus Consortium, which is formed by Ocean Winds, Principle Power, and Repsol. The success of the project is highly connected with the success of the operational phase. These platforms will sit offshore for 25 years. Ensuring that the lifetime of the project is achieved is to a large extent connected with the success of the operational phase of the project and the O&M activities. The key aspect of operating and maintaining floating offshore wind farms is availability. It's uptime. We need to ensure that the turbines are spinning and generating power to the most extent possible. The uniqueness about operating and maintaining a floating offshore wind farm is that we're adding more parts to be maintained. And that maintenance cannot increase any downtime. We don't want any downtime, so we need to ensure that we are efficient in planning and executing the operations in a way that no further downtime is added to the park, despite of having a floating platform to be maintained. This building is the base for all operations to be taken on the WindFloat Atlantic project during the lifetime of the project. We do and we plan all the operational activities. We set up to go offshore from here and we host at this warehouse all the equipment and parts that are required to maintain a floating offshore wind farm. Typically, the O&M activities lay in three pillars. Preventive maintenance, activities that need to be conducted in order to ensure that equipment does not fail. Corrective maintenance, equipments that need to be conducted because eventually at some point equipment are prone to failure, and inspections. Inspections are different activities that are undertaken in order to ensure that the structural integrity of the platform is never compromised. Floating offshore wind has leveraged a lot from different other similar industries such as oil and gas or fixed offshore wind. All of those learnings from operating assets offshore are integrated here on our maintenance plan, ensuring that we have the highest availability while conducting a scope that will ensure that our client, the WindFloat Atlantic project owners, take the most value of the asset installed. The uniqueness of this operation lies in the fact that we are conducting fairly simple activities in an offshore environment. And as such, there are constraints in terms of quality, health and safety that need to be accounted for and that add on complexity, but are absolutely fundamental for safe offshore operations. Remote monitoring is a key aspect of the operational and maintenance phase of the projects. Remote monitoring enables us to have a look at key parameters and key aspects of the operation, even if we're not offshore. Right. With this information that we get from offshore on an onshore center, we can collect information on, for example, is the asset performed as designed? Is the asset performing as should? And if there are discrepancies between those both status, as designed, as should, and as is, we can plan interventions in a way that it causes the minimum downtime to the project in the most efficient possible way. Digitalization is also a key aspect of this phase of the project, and we've been hosting several initiatives around this space, such as development of digital twin solutions for floating offshore wind farm applications, The importance or the relevance of such an effort really lies in, for example, in moving from a schedule-based inspection program onto a risk-based inspection program. And again, the relevance of this is optimization of offshore operations and uptime. If instead of going offshore because we have a schedule to fulfill, we're going offshore because we understand the real status of components and structure, then we will be able to plan operations in the most efficient way, ensuring the most uptime. Offshore operations do not start offshore. Offshore operations starts with a diligent planning onshore. In here, we have a look at the activity that needs to be conducted, the equipment that is required, and if applicable, additional resources or techniques that need to be accounted for. O&M in the floating offshore wind context has two main stages, above water and underwater. For underwater inspections, we resource ourselves with vessels and ROVs, remotely operated vehicles, that are capable of diving and conducting a general visual inspection of the structure in key parts that we define that are most prone to fatigue, for example. To me, the operational and maintenance phase of the project is the most exciting phase of the lifetime of a project. This is the phase where we ensure that the lifetime, the design life of the project is achieved with the most successful energetic output for the project.